In this video, you will learn how to build a Google Chat app with AppScript, leverage the Chat API to create a space and message, and use Vertex AI to summarize the conversations in a chat space. Before we start coding, let's have a look at the workflow of the solution we're going to build. Our chat app will respond to incidents in real time. An incident is an event that requires the immediate attention of a team of people to resolve. Examples of incidents include: a time-sensitive case is created in a customer relationship management platform, requiring a team to collaborate on a resolution. A system goes offline, alerting a group of site reliability engineers so that they can work together to bring it back online. A natural disaster occurs and emergency workers need to coordinate their response. For the purpose of this tutorial, the incident alert starts when someone reports the incident with a button click from a web page. The webpage simulates an incident by asking users to enter basic incident information, title, description, and email addresses of the responders. Note that we are using a webpage to simulate an external system. Such a system could be a CRM platform, an incident management system, an HR system, or more. Once the chat app receives the incident, it creates and populates a chat space. The chat app posts a message summarizing the incident to the space based on the input the user submitted. The incident responders can use the dedicated space to collaborate on finding a solution for the problem. When the problem is resolved, one of the users starts the incident resolution process by using a slash command to invoke the app. In response, the app displays a dialog that prompts the user to enter a resolution description and close the incident. The chat app collects all the messages in the space and sends them to Vertex AI. In turn, Vertex AI summarizes the conversation. Next, a retrospective Google Docs document is created. The Vertex AI summary is inserted into the document, which is then shared in the chat space. Now that we know how the chat app assists with incident management, it's time to start building it. To do so, we will need a Google Workspace account with access to Google Chat, and the directory for Google Workspace has to be turned on. The incident app uses the directory to look up the incident responder's contact info, like name and email address. Incident responders must be users with a Google Chat account in our Google Workspace organization. We also need access to the Google Cloud Console as well as to Vertex AI. If you need any of these prerequisites turned on for your organization, ask your Google Workspace administrator to do so. We start by creating a Google Cloud project. This we do in the Google Cloud Console. In the Project Name field, enter a descriptive name for your project and select a location. Your administrator may have already set a default location or billing account for your projects. If not, select one before creating your project. Once you have created the project, the Google Cloud Console navigates to the dashboard page and your project is created within a few minutes. The next step is to enable billing for the cloud project we just created. Navigate to the billing section and choose My Projects. Open the Actions menu where you can choose your cloud billing account and set it. Choose the organization that is associated with your cloud project. If you're unable to link a billing account, you don't have the permissions needed to make this change. In that case, check out the permissions required to enable billing link in the description of this video. Next, we enable the APIs that our app will be using. We enable the Google Chat API, the Google Docs API, the Admin SDK API, and the Vertex AI API. For the chat app to access resources in Google Workspace and Google Cloud to process an incident response, we set up authentication and authorization. In this tutorial, we published the app internally, so it's okay to use placeholder information. If you plan to publish this app externally, replace placeholder information with real information for the consent screen. If you want to learn more about publishing an app, check out the video How to Publish an App to the Google Workspace Marketplace linked in the top right corner of this video right about now. We navigate to the OAuth consent screen in the Google Cloud Console. We select User Type Internal and name our app Incident Management. Select your email address or an appropriate Google group as a recipient of user support emails. Under Developer Contact Information, enter your email address and proceed to the next section. We will be adding the necessary authorization for our chat app with these 9 scopes. If necessary, pause the video here to add all the scopes to the auth configuration. After all the scopes have been added, we return to the dashboard. We will be connecting our Google Cloud project with the AppScript project, which we will create in the next step. To achieve this, we will be needing the Cloud project number and ID, both located in the project settings. Copy the project ID and keep the project settings open in this tab, as we will be coming back to it in the next step. Next, we create the AppScript project in a new tab. You can copy and update the entire AppScript project that contains all the required application code for our chat app. You see the link on screen and we'll also find it in the description of this video. Optionally, you can view the entire project on GitHub. That link too you will find in the description of this video. Once we have accessed the AppScript project, we make a copy of it. We name our copy of the AppScript project. In our copy of the AppScript project in the const.js file, we replace your project ID with the ID of our cloud project. If your Google Cloud project is located in a region other than US Central 1, please add your corresponding location to Vertex AI location ID in the AppScript project. At the time of production, generative AI on Vertex AI has limited regional availability, so we will set Vertex AI location ID to US Central 1. If you wish to use a different region, check the Generative AI on Vertex AI Locations documentation to see currently supported regions. It's time to connect our Google Cloud project with the AppScript project we just created. For that, we copy the project number in the Google Cloud console, then we navigate to the project settings in our AppScript project. There we paste the project number of our cloud project. The Cloud project and AppScript project are now connected. Now that all the code is in place, we deploy the AppScript project. We do so in the AppScript IDE in the Deploy interface. If Add-on and Web App aren't already selected, next to Select Type, click Deployment Types and select Add-on and Web App. We enter description for this version. We select that the Web App executes as the user accessing the Web App and that anyone within our workspace organization has access to it. Once we have deployed the project, we are provided with a deployment ID and a URL for the incident initialization webpage. Copy the deployment ID as we will be needing it in the coming step. Keep this user interface open as we will come back to it later. Back in our Google Cloud project, we configure the chat app. We access the configuration of the chat API, which we enabled previously. On this tab, we add the app name, avatar URL, and description. Since we want the users to be able to interact with our chat app, we enable the interactive features. We configure our chat app to be able to receive one-on-one messages, as well as join spaces and group conversations. We choose AppScript project as our connection settings and paste the AppScript deployment ID that we copied earlier from the AppScript project deployment. We want the users to be able to start the closing of the incident process in the chat app. For that, we add the corresponding slash command and define that invoking it will open a dialog. We define that this chat app is available to specific people and groups in our workspace domain, and we enter our email address. We choose to log chat app errors to logging. Lastly, we save our configuration. Next up is the testing of our chat app. To do so, we initiate an incident from the web page. The URL for that page is found in the deployment user interface in our AppScript project. AppScript asks permission to access our data. We review permissions and sign in with an appropriate Google account in our Google Workspace domain. Let's enter some test information. We are going to add the email addresses of fellow incident responders. They must be users with a Google Chat account in our Google Workspace organization. We won't enter our own email address because it's included automatically. We add an initial message and initiate the creation of the chat space. The message that appears confirms that the space has been created and we can now open it in chat. All the previously defined incident responders can send messages in the space. To end the incident response and begin the resolution process in the chat space, We type the slash command we configured in the chat API. In the incident management dialog that opens, we enter a description for the incident resolution and close the incident. The incident management app lists the messages in the space, summarizes them with Vertex AI, pastes the summary in a Google Docs document, and shares the document in the space. To avoid incurring charges to your Google Cloud accounts for the resources used in this tutorial, we recommend that you delete the cloud project. We delete the project in the Manage Resources page in the Google Cloud console. You can find this tutorial in the developer documentation. We have added a link to the tutorial in the description of this video. If you want to learn more about creating chat apps, check out the videos on screen. And make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos about Google Chat apps and Google Workspace development in general.